This is Silicon Valley, home to the world's tech giants, a bustling hub of startups, billions of dollars in investor capital, and everything in between.
This is where it all started, 367 Addison Avenue in Palo Alto, California, known to be the birthplace of Silicon Valley. Because in 1938, Hewlett-Packard began developing its first product right over there in that garage. So fast forward to 2017, where is Silicon Valley now and where is it headed?
According to the Director of Technology Management at Stanford University, investors in Silicon Valley have shifted their attention to entrepreneurs outside of the valley, particularly in emerging markets. Investor interest in Southeast Asia, Dasher adds, puts the Philippines in an opportune position.
I visited the Philippines a couple of times. What you see is an economy that is moving from developing to developed, and so there are a lot of everyday needs that the entrepreneurs are facing. And I think that there is a kind of global awareness.
Case in point, Zipmatch.com,
a startup born in the Philippines
that primarily caters to the Philippine market, but with a service that has the potential to cater to the global market as well. Zipmatch.com takes various real estate listings and puts it all on one online forum, creating a real estate marketplace for buyers, sellers, investors, and other interested parties. Zipmatch.com became the first Philippine startup accepted to Google's accelerator program.
One of the reasons why they chose us, so we did this 360-degree virtual reality or tours. So that was kind of pushing the envelope as to really innovating how the buying process of a home or renting process of a home is.
We are Miraculous from Mexico.
We are Ruang Guru from Indonesia.
We help professionals. Since Zipmatch.com's acceptance to Google Launchpad, two more startups from the Philippines have been accepted into the prestigious accelerator program, Bloom Solutions and Honesty Apps.
When I invented that and then sold it to Snapchat.
Filipino-American Garrett G knows just what a huge investment in a small company can do. His startup Scan sold to Snapchat for $54 million in 2014. But before the sale that changed his life, came an investment from Google.
Google and those other investors, they gave us $1.7 million to take our little baby app and try to make it into something bigger.
It has become the new Cinderella story, a tech giant investing in a small startup, taking that business to new heights and disrupting existing markets. We'll find out more about those stories and break down the tech scene every week right here on Tech Discovery with me, Ginger Conejero.